It never got into full production phase due to the issues with the various contractors, and only 1,000 units were ever built. So when you consider the history, it's actually pretty awesome that Treyarch did their research and found this prototype weapon and put it in their game. What's worse than a one-and-done gun? Well, a one-and-done gun in Call of Duty that was actually a really good gun. What is up, everybody? Chaos here. Welcome to Chaos Gaming. Today, we're going to be looking at some of the best one-and-done guns in COD history. These are those guns that only made one appearance and then they were done for whatever reason. We have not seen them ever since. We're going to start one off. Well, we're going to go with one of my favorites, and a lot of people hate it. It's ugly, but man, was this thing smooth. The Enfield in Black Ops 1. This is a gun that I have expressed plenty of love for throughout the years. The Enfield was a full auto bullpup assault rifle, and it was one of the very first guns that you unlocked in the multiplayer of the original Black Ops. Now, it's a pretty standard weapon. It has moderate fire rate, solid damage, kills in 3 to 4 shots pretty much anywhere, low recoil, and a very sweet firing sound and reload animation. But due to it being unlocked so early and the fact that Black Ops was dominated by the FAMAS, the Enfield didn't get much love at all. But it is fun to look back at and reminisce. It does also seem like it developed a bit of a cult following over the years. Maybe because I brought it up so many times, I don't know. There's always people in the comments saying how much they loved it, just like I did. I think it's a perfect way to start today's list, and I want them to bring it back. At number 9, the M249 Saw in COD 4. This is one of those guns that everybody recognizes, and it's appeared in quite a few of the campaigns. But in terms of multiplayer, it's only actually ever been in one Call of Duty game. That's right. Call of Duty 4 featured this gun as your starting LMG, and it was also one of the fastest firing guns in the entire game. It would fire at 937 rounds per minute. That's an LMG, people, while hitting for a flat 30 damage from all ranges without stopping power. Now, one of the best ways to run this gun was with a foregrip and the steady aim perk, so you could just walk around hip firing people and shredding them to pieces like you were John Rambo. The M249 returned in the campaign of Modern Warfare 2, but not the multiplayer for some reason. You can still find it in the game files of Black Ops 1 and Modern Warfare 3, but it's not actually in the game. So despite it being so recognizable, it's only actually been usable in one Call of Duty multiplayer experience. At number 8, the Stakeout in Black Ops 1. Now, shotguns were pretty lackluster, to say the least, in the original Black Ops. Thankfully, there was one standout, the Stakeout. It was arguably the best shotgun in the game, although I still think the Black Ops 1 Spaz was pretty dirty if you did it right, and it had easily the best one-shot range in the entire class. Now, the Stakeout boasted a very tight hip-fire spread, especially for a shotgun, which made it easy to stack up pellet bonuses and make the one-shot kill range even more intimidating. The only problem with it was the ammo capacity. By default, you could only hold 4 shells at once, so you would be reloading constantly, and if you weren't running sleight of hand, this could get pretty painful. However, if you knew how to play the weapon to its strengths, you could get a lot of work done with the Stakeout, and since it never showed up in another Call of Duty game, I thought it deserved a shout. Next up is the AS-50 in Modern Warfare 3. Raise your hand if you remember this gun. Now, MW3 was jam-packed with sniper rifles, and most people stuck to the MSR, the L118, and the Barrett, but there was one sniper that actually hit harder than all of those, but it didn't get much love. The AS-50. It was unlocked at level 22. It had the highest bullet damage in the entire game. It hit for 98 base damage with multipliers from the stomach all the way to the top of your head, making it almost always a one-shot kill. Now, the downside was the hindered movement, as the AS-50 would make you run slower, which was a bit of a drag in a game like Modern Warfare 3, where you wanted to be zipping around every corner like everybody else. It also had a 2x4 scope by default instead of the 4x8 that all the other snipers had, which made it a great choice for playing aggressive and focusing on mid-range encounters. It was a good gun. It was that nice middle ground between the Barrett and the MSR. Unfortunately, after Modern Warfare 3, we never saw it in another mainline COD game. It popped up in COD Online and COD Mobile is the Arctic 50, but as for the main games, the AS-50 was one and done. At number 6, raise your hand on this one. Do you remember the MG4 in Modern Warfare 2? Most of you are not going to remember this. I don't care if you say you do. If you do, I think you're lying. Now, Modern Warfare 2 had a ton of standout weapons, but there was a few that got lost with time. One of these was the MG4, a light machine gun that had some of the best stats in its class, but for whatever reason, it was often passed up in favor of the AUG or the RPD. It came equipped with a hefty 100 round mag. It fired at almost 900 rounds per minute, and it dealt a flat 30 damage at all ranges with no stopping power. It made it a 4-shot kill from any distance on the map, or a 3-shot if you were using stopping power. The recoil, it was low. You could pretty much remove it entirely by putting a grip attachment on, meaning you could easily pick people off across the map. It made it such an underrated monster on the larger, more open maps where you could just set up shop somewhere and tag people as they ran by. The MG4 was a ton of fun to use, but due to it not being all that popular both in the game and in real life, well, it never made another return in another Call of Duty game. At number 5, the G11 in Black Ops, one of the weirdest guns, to say the least, in COD history and also in real world history. The G11 is a 3-round burst assault rifle, and it was arguably one of the best guns in Black Ops 1, despite it getting overshadowed by the FAMAS, like basically everything else did in the game. Now, believe it or not, the G11 is actually a real gun, although it never made it into full production. It was prototyped by a gun manufacturer during the 60s, 70s, and 80s, but it never got into full production phase due to the issues with the various contractors, and only 1,000 units were ever built. So when you consider the history, it's actually pretty awesome that Treyarch did their research and found this prototype weapon and put it in their game. The Black Ops G11 would fire in a 3-round burst at 1,250 rounds per minute, hit between 35 and 25 damage, easily killing in one burst. It also had no recoil. It made it super easy to laser people from across the map. It was an awesome gun, and I hope we see it make a return in the future, perhaps with a Black Ops reboot in 2020. At number 4, the G3 in COD 4, one of the shortest gun names in COD history. The G3 appeared in COD 4 as a very underrated assault rifle, and then poof, it was gone forever. It was a semi-automatic rifle that would deal up to 40 damage without stopping power and 56 with stopping power, which made it a 2-to-3-shot kill. Now, most semi-automatic rifles in modern COD games, they have a pretty low fire rate cap, making their DPS rather lackluster. But the G3 had a ridiculous cap of 1,250 rounds per minute, meaning if you had a good trigger finger, you could erase people from the map before they realized what was happening. The G3 also had very low recoil and a hefty 20-round mag, which made it easy to spam and get those cheesy killstreaks with. Unfortunately, it wasn't really a standout weapon back in COD 4. None of the COD developers ever saw a reason to bring it back. You can find it in the game files of Modern Warfare 2, which implied that it was there some point in development, but it was cut before the game went gold. At number 3, I love this name and I love this gun. The Stoner 63 in Black Ops 1. It's a real gun. This 5.56 light machine gun was designed by Eugene Stoner in the early 60s, and it was used by the U.S. Marines and the Navy SEALs all the way up into the 80s when it was retired, replaced by the M249 SAW. Now, the real-world equivalent, the Black Ops Stoner, is a middle ground between a rifle and an LMG. It boasts a smaller mag and faster handling, but it still hit hard and it spit the bullets out. The Black Ops 1 Stoner would hit for 40 damage flat, which made it a 3-shot kill at all ranges, 2 shots if you landed headshots, and it would fire at a blazing 937 rounds per minute. Now, the recoil was pretty manageable, and it could shred through cover easily. The only downside was a long reload animation. It clocked in just under 4 seconds, and many people skipped over it in favor of something like the FAMAS or the AUG, but if you used it, you knew it was a beast. At number 2, the CM901 in Modern Warfare 3. I liked this gun. I really did. It was an assault rifle unlocked at level 18, and it boasted the highest damage of any automatic weapon in the entire game. The entire game, people, okay? The CM901 would deal 49 base damage up close, and then it would decrease down to 25 at range. It made it a 3-to-4-shot kill without any headshots, but if you landed just one headshot, it would drop the target with 2 bullets. In fact, the CM901 was the only automatic gun in Modern Warfare 3 that was capable of a 2-shot kill. The more you know, right? It also fired at a respectable 666 rounds per minute, and it had an awesome reload animation. But the downside was the recoil. It kicked a lot, and it was very hard to predict, which made it difficult to take full advantage of its high damage output. I guess that's their way of balancing it. Nevertheless, it was a beast if you knew how to play it to its strengths. And after Modern Warfare 3, we never saw this beast again. And at number 1, finishing it off is a gun that I'm honestly super surprised we never saw again. The M40A3 in COD 4, such an iconic weapon and one of the most important snipers in COD history, as it pretty much gave birth to quickscoping and YouTube montages. Now, this was your starting rifle in COD 4, your starting sniper rifle, and it would deal 70 base damage with multipliers to the stomach all the way through the head, which made it virtually always a 1-shot kill if you use stopping power, that is, unless the other person was using Juggernaut. It also boasted very high cover penetration, which made it easy to wallbang people, especially if you had deep impact on your class. And weirdly enough, The M40A3 was the weakest sniper in the game in terms of base damage, but you wouldn't really be able to tell due to how consistent it was. I mean, it just goes to show how beefy the snipers in COD 4 were all the way around. Despite how much of an impact it had and how much people loved it, it never made a return in another mainline COD game. Now, it can be found briefly in Modern Warfare 2 Spec Ops mode, but it never made a full return. And personally, I'm surprised that we never saw it come back, and I don't know if I disagree or agree with the decision to let it rest. It was such an important weapon in the COD community. Maybe they just wanted to preserve its legacy. I don't know. You guys, let me know what you think. What is another one-and-done gun that did not make this list that was deserving? On the screen now are two videos, a red video and a blue video. Today, I would request that you click the red video. I'll see you over there.